Few players in Premier League history are so shrouded in myth than Marco Boogers, the tall striker infamous for his short stint at West Ham in 1995. This is the story of how a player who made just 4 substitute appearances in the Premier League became one of the most famous and mysterious foreign signings in English football history. Our story begins just before the 1995-96 season. Manager Harry Redknapp is looking for a big striker to partner Tony Cotti up front. Somebody sends him a videotape of a 28-year-old from Sparta Rotterdam named Marco Boogers. Now, this video story is disputed. Both the club and Boogers himself claimed that scouts had seen him play multiple times that season, and the player even claimed there would be an interest from Napoli, Everton and Borussia Dortmund. Boogers had been a regular goal scorer in both the Eredivisie and Eredivisie for Utrecht, RKC and Sparta Rotterdam. He had also come third in the previous season's Player of the Year award, the same season that Ajax had won the Champions League. It all looked very promising. West Ham picked him up for just under £1 million, arriving alongside a Romanian international Ilie Dumitrescu and the Portuguese midfielder Dani. It seemed a good piece of business, but things started to turn sour quickly. He was skinny, much thinner than the tall and powerful forward that Redknapp had expected. He was described by his new bosses lazy in training, and started the Hammers' first game of the season against Leeds on the bench, coming on during the second half to no real effect. The team went to Old Trafford for their next match and found themselves losing 2-1 thanks to goals from Keane and Scholes, either side of a Steve Bruce own goal. With just under 20 minutes remaining, Redknapp sends on Boogers, and within 2 minutes he'd made his mark on English football.
And West Ham fans getting their first view here of Marco Boogers, signed from Sparta Rotterdam. The Dutchman brought on now to pep up West Ham's attacking ideas. Sharp picking over from Butt. Still West Ham mainly on the defensive here. Bruce. Now Neville. Oh, dreadful tackle there by Boogers. Well, his enthusiasm clearly got the better of him there. That was an awful lunge at Gary Neville, which understandably has left him in anguish. And I think Boogers is going to be sent off here, and he can really have no complaints.
That horror tackle on Gary Neville led to a straight red and a 4-game ban. The club allowed him to return to his hometown of Dordrecht for the duration of his suspension. If he thought that there he could avoid detention, he was sorely mistaken. A few days later, a club call reporter rang the club, looking to get an interview with Marco. Instead, West Ham's travel arranger picked up, who told the reporter, if he's gone back to Holland, he's probably gone by car again. But this was misinterpreted as, if he's gone back to Holland, he's probably gone to his caravan. The next day, the Sun's back page headline read, Barmy Boogers living in a caravan. Boogers did return after his ban. The press claimed he came with a note which said he was psychologically unfit to play football. But he would make only 2 more appearances, both off the bench, against Blackburn and Aston Villa, before a knee problem which had gone undetected during his medical ended his brief time in East London. He returned to his homeland to recover, joining FC Groningen on loan for the rest of the season, but wouldn't make an appearance. After that, he'd score regularly in the Eredivisie for Volendam, RKC again, and his hometown club, Dordrecht, where he worked as sporting director until 2017. Boogers' time in England is symptomatic of a different attitude to mental health and the struggles foreign players face when coming to the Premier League. Neither he nor his wife spoke much English, and he's since spoken of his homesickness. In 2003, Harry Redknapp said, "It's not right, because we expect them to arrive and settle in just like that. There's no aftercare, it's not on, but that's how it was at West Ham. Now it's different at the top clubs, who employ people to look after the foreigners."